Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Parents Who Lead, the leadership approach you need to parent with purpose, fuel your career, and create a richer life. By Stewart D. Friedman and Alyssa F. Westring. Narrated by Graham Rowat. Publisher's note. This audiobook has bonus material of visual elements supporting the text. Please contact whomever you purchased this audiobook from to request the material. Preface. Why we wrote this book. We wrote this book to bring the science of leadership to the art of parenting. We want to help you lift your head up and out of the chaos and craft a way, together with your family, to build something different. Something that serves your career, your life as a parent, and your other aspirations in life. As researchers, educators, consultants, and coaches, we have decades of experience helping people learn how to succeed as they aim to have a positive impact in their work, in their communities, and at home, as leaders in all aspects of life. We know it can be better, and you can make it so. In striving to be the parent you want to be, have a fruitful career, find time to nurture important relationships, engage as a citizen, and make sure you stay healthy and sane. And we know that doing all this is very difficult. You are not alone. Yet many parents worry that they're among the unfortunate few who haven't figured it all out. Through their work with us, they're happily surprised, relieved, really, to find that nearly everyone is struggling, albeit in their own distinct ways. We've seen parents find greater harmony, as well as better performance in all parts of their lives, by viewing things in a new way. Observing how other parents wrestle with the demands of modern life and how they apply our proven principles and tools gives people both greater confidence and the resources to pursue the lives they want to lead. We expect this is what you're trying to do. Forge a life that's fulfilling, creative, and meaningful for you, your family, your work, and your community. To make our research-based model available to you so you can use it to make your world better is our raison d'être. But there's a bit more to the story of why we produce this new leadership approach designed just for parents. From Stu. After getting my PhD in organizational psychology from the University of Michigan, my early career as a management professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania was focused on understanding what makes effective leaders. After having my first child, over 30 years ago, however, I pivoted, as I viscerally realized something I had learned as a student from seminal scholars in my field. People don't just shelve the other parts of their lives when they are at work. I started talking about this with anyone who would listen. The idea of accounting for the whole person at work wasn't mainstream, either in business schools or in business culture in the late 1980s and early 1990s, when much of the focus in the emerging field of work and life was, appropriately, devoted to women being supported in their quest to work outside the home in their chosen profession and be treated as equals to men at work. I became one of the accidental spokesmen in a new conversation about work and life. Emphasis added because, at the time, I was one of the few men interested in this topic. It's gratifying to see that there's been progress since those days. Yet it is undeniable that we still have a long way to go. So I've continued to pursue practical knowledge for how to create harmony among the different parts of life in my research, teaching, consulting, and advocacy. My students at the Wharton School, especially those in our executive MBA program, where I've been teaching the course that gave rise to this book for over 15 years, have been clamoring for me to produce a guide for parents. So this book is, in part, a response to their interest. But my motivation for working on this book stems even more profoundly from my family. My life partner, Hallie, and I have three children, now in their 20s and 30s. When I turned 65 a few years back, the only gift I asked for from these four precious people was this. Write to me about what you'd like me to focus on in my remaining years and how, by my doing so, your life would be enriched, and be willing to talk this over for an hour, one-on-one. Yes, the professor gave his family an assignment. Among other things, they told me, each in their own way, how my research on parents applying leadership principles might help our family and be of some value to society. I came away from these conversations further inspired to write this book, for them and for you. But I needed a research partner and friend whose experience as a working mother from a generation after mine and knowledge as an accomplished scholar could inform what I might be able to say on my own. From Alyssa. By the time I graduated from college, I knew I wanted to dedicate my career to the science and psychology of helping people thrive in both their careers and personal lives. It is no coincidence I was passionate about this topic, considering I was already starting to fret about navigating my future career and raising my hypothetical children. This was more than a decade before I actually had them. While pursuing my PhD in organizational psychology at Michigan State University, my academic research was flourishing, but I longed to make an impact on people's lives. I searched for scholars doing this work on the front lines. Stu's work was evidence-based and practical. I emailed him and asked if we could work together. In the 13 years since, Stu has become a mentor, and I have become director of research for our company, Total Leadership. My role is to determine what's working and what's not as we continually improve our model, which helps individuals and organizations create sustainable change that increases performance in all parts of life by finding greater harmony among them. As I became a tenured professor of management and entrepreneurship at DePaul University, we've continued to collaborate, culminating in this book. I've found a career path that allows me to bridge the gap between academic research and people's daily experience. I couldn't be happier about it. At 39, I am a youngish working mom with two youngish kids, ages 8 and 10. In fact, Time magazine interviewed me as a millennial mom for its cover story, "Help, My Parents Are Millennials." While I might not be considered myself a millennial, I do feel connected with the challenges of being a working parent today. From learning that my mom was diagnosed with brain cancer just a week before starting my tenure-track job, to my husband's unexpected stint as a stay-at-home dad, I've ridden the roller coaster of working parenthood and have amassed my own trove of epiphanies and embarrassing stories. I've been there. Rather, I am there. In fact, in one of the video interviews we did as part of our research for this book, my husband is chasing my naked daughter around our living room behind me while I try to remain focused. While there's no one right way, Stu and I can help you find what works for you and your family based on our own research, the scholarship in our field, and our experience working with clients and students, from undergraduates to executive MBAs. For the benefit of the world today, as well as the world of tomorrow, your children's world, you need to lead. We invite you to join us as we provide you with the tools we've developed so that you can achieve greater connection, engagement, and success, as you define it, in the modern world of 24/7 demands, the digital deluge, revolutionized gender roles, political tensions, and the increasing fragility of human existence on Earth. Chapter 1. The Leadership Challenge of Your Life. Dina Altman and Jake Center met as 15-year-olds in summer camp, although they didn't start dating until their mid-20s, when they were living in New York City. After 3 years, they got married and now have two energetic boys, Ian, 7, and Casey, 4. Jake is a practicing attorney in Charleston, South Carolina. He recently began studying transcendental meditation, but this doesn't eliminate the stress he feels as he tries to keep up at work and be present for his family. After college, Dina started a career in marketing, but she recently switched to nonprofit management, seeking work that felt more personally meaningful. Dina was 1 week into a busy new job as executive director of a nonprofit foundation, and Jake was chugging steadily toward becoming a partner at his firm when we began our work with him. On the surface, the big picture stuff seemed to be going well. They both cared about their careers and about their relationships with each other and their children. As we got to know them, they confessed that they were constantly rushing, always playing catch-up, barely staying on top of their workloads, and struggling to squeeze enjoyment from their side-by-side lives. Jake put it this way, "When things are stressful at work, I feel even more overwhelmed at home. I can be short-tempered with Dina and the boys. I'll snap at them. I regret this. I don't like that work takes so much of my attention, but I don't see any way around it." Dina faces daunting challenges too, if a bit different. Work distracts me at home, and even when I'm in the car with Jake or with the kids, largely because of email, texts, and constant chirps from my stupid phone. I feel guilty that I'm not present enough for my family, that I'm not a good mom, and that I need to pay more attention to my marriage. Even though I know better, I just can't seem to stop myself from jumping in when the latest crisis at work hits. I often feel disconnected from the very people I most want to feel connected to. Sensing that their lives weren't what they wanted them to be, they agreed, though not without some trepidation, to participate in our workshop designed expressly for parents, based on the program described in Stu's book, Total Leadership: Be a Better Leader, Have a Richer Life. Total Leadership and the Pursuit of Four-Way Wins. In the 2008 book, Total Leadership, Stu introduced the idea of the four-way win, a new way of looking at the connections among the different parts of life and then taking action to improve performance at work, at home, in the community, and for yourself personally, mind, body, and spirit. This reframes the idea of work-life balance, which implies sacrifice in one part for success in another. It doesn't always have to be a zero-sum game. Instead, the total leadership approach focuses on creating harmony, or integration, among all the aspects of our lives, which can be achieved by being real, acting with authenticity by clarifying what's important, being whole, acting with integrity by respecting the whole person, and being innovative, acting with creativity by continually experimenting with how things get done. Evidence from studies of parents who have used this approach found that they significantly increased their satisfaction with their careers by 17%, with their family lives by 31%, with their community engagement by 39%, and with their personal well-being by 54%. Moreover, they report a 23% improvement in both their physical and mental health, as well as a 31% reduction in stress. If you've read Total Leadership, you might recognize some of the basic principles in this book, but they're applied in a new way here. If you're not familiar with Total Leadership, don't worry. We'll supply the fundamentals, redesigned to help parents meet the leadership challenges they face. In this book, we will show you, as a parent, how to take the four-way view of your world, systematically observing your life as a whole, rather than as an endless series of trade-offs. You'll form a new appreciation for how no one part exists in isolation, so you can make better decisions about how to invest your most precious asset. That is, your attention. You'll get smarter about how to manage boundaries between, for example, work and family. Taking the four-way view will give you fresh insights about how work, family, community, and your private self all affect each other, in your life and in your partner's too. You'll then generate practical, exciting ideas for your family to pursue four-way wins, customized by you to fit sustainably in your world. Like Total Leadership, this book is not about survival tactics or life hacks, but is instead a proven guide for building lives of significance, with the emphasis here on what it means to do so if you're a parent. The method we describe and illustrate gets results because there's no one best way. No one-size-fits-all, no fixed prescription. What is required is to consciously choose what matters, connect with who matters, and create innovative ways to make things better. Most of the people who join our workshops, some of whose stories are in this book, although names and other identifying information have been changed for privacy, have a similar sense of their lives barreling along, but that they're not in the driver's seat. We were not surprised to find how many people in parenting partnerships feel as Dina and Jake do. By parenting partnerships, we mean relationships of shared responsibility for raising children, which often means married couples, though not always. Many people feel alone in their strife. They want things to be different, but they're mired in ways of thinking and acting that are no longer working and, as important, they don't believe there's a better way. They're not sure where to turn for advice or how to gain a greater sense of control and to create meaningful change. You probably picked up this book because you too are feeling that you're not leading the life you really want as a parent. Perhaps you're just plain tired. Tired of trying to coordinate busy work schedules with your parenting partner. Tired of waiting for things to settle down. Tired of feeling as if you aren't being your best self at work, in your most intimate relationships, and with your community of friends and extended family. and probably tired because you don't sleep enough. You are not alone. As parents, we've been there too, and we've worked with people like you who have been there. Here are some of the things we hear from parents when we start working with them. I'm letting people down. My kids, coworkers, partner, and friends deserve better. There's not enough time for me to be the kind of parent I want to be. If I could just get my act together, I could have it all. I need to completely overhaul my life to make things work. I don't have control of my situation, so I can't really change the way things are. Other people don't understand what I'm going through. I'm really on my own. People are too busy to help me, and I don't want to bother them. My partner and I can't find much common ground on parenting. I'm not a leader. If you're holding any of these assumptions, either consciously or not, you're bound to be undermining your own success. But our evidence shows that you can change your thinking and, by adopting leadership principles and tools, challenge assumptions, see your life in a new way, and find greater harmony and better performance in all aspects of your life. Drawing on the scientific literature in psychology, sociology, and leadership studies, we've developed a leadership approach that is specifically designed for parenting partnerships in which the members have careers, whether or not both are currently employed outside the home. We have found that developing as a leader has much in common with growing as a parent. The process of creative change starts with you. It just might be that the way you think about parenting and its place in your life is holding you back. Through the activities we lay out here, some of which you will undertake alone, and some together with your partner in parenting, you'll come to see that your assumptions about what it takes to perform well in all your life's roles, especially as a parent, might be misguided. Through discovery, dialogue, and design of new ideas, we'll guide you to systematically take actions that will enable you to test these assumptions, and, if you become aware of how they're causing unnecessary frustration or even failure, to alter them. While we can't make everything easy, perfect, and without some sacrifice, we'll show you how to explore the values that unite you, the passions that drive you, and the vision you hold collectively for the future, for your children. We'll provide you with tools you can use to define success on your own terms, connect more meaningfully with people in your life, and try innovative ways to nurture your career, your family, however you define it, your community, and your personal well-being. Parent with purpose, fuel your career, and create a richer life. It might not seem obvious at first, but raising children is a leadership challenge, perhaps the most important one you'll ever face. Being a parent requires seemingly endless amounts of energy and patience, illuminates our shortcomings, and mystifies us at every turn. As we try to lead our children toward happy, compassionate, and confident lives, we must figure out how to do so, while at the same time investing in what matters most to us elsewhere in life. At some point on the journey with us, most of the parents in our workshops feel a jolt. The realization that as parents, they are indeed leaders, capable of mobilizing others toward a goal that matters, and that growing as a leader isn't just about work, it's about life. Whether or not they are in an official leadership role at work, they realize they have the capacity to inspire. Rather than seeing themselves as mere administrators of their lives, reactively overseeing to-do lists, they start to view themselves as leaders who are consciously designing an achievable future, the one they truly want, and showing the people around them how to make that feast a reality they can savor together. Our goals are to educate and to provoke, to push you to think of yourself as a leader and act like one, but not in the traditional sense of having formal authority, or of being in charge of people in an organization hierarchy or political setting. Leaders are those who see how to improve things and inspire people to pursue a better future together. Let's now take a more detailed look at the leadership approach we'll explore in this book. In the chapters that follow, we'll describe the actions you can take, on your own and then together as a partnership. Most people find it takes a few months to methodically work through the book's activities, in light of the other responsibilities in their lives. You'll articulate what really matters, build trust and strengthen relationships with your most important people, and develop creative ways to be more of who you want to be. We'll explain what we want you to do and why. Along the way, we'll dive into the stories of some of the parenting partnerships, people like Dina Altman and Jake Center, who have teamed up with us to increase their dexterity in working together to parent with purpose and find greater harmony. We'll expect you'll see some of your own experience reflected in these stories, and this will help you compose your own stories about the adventures you have in learning to live in closer accord with your values. Envision your future together. A leader has a vision of a future that's better than today. To get excited about changing in meaningful ways, you need to be able to vividly picture what you want your life to look like. You might find it easy to do that, though not everyone does. And when your life is intertwined with others, the challenge is greater, as it becomes envisioning a future that you, your partner, and your children want. This vision should allow each of you the flexibility to pursue your individual passions and fulfill your most important values, while uniting you in shared dreams. You'll come together to create what we call a collective vision, to align and start to see new interconnections between one another and among various domains of your lives. We'll guide you through the inevitable challenges that arise when you realize that your dreams and your partner's may not be entirely in sync, and we'll help you learn how to get to common ground. We'll advise you on defining the path you want to walk together and on seeing how, in your everyday life on that path, you serve as a role model for the next generation. No two visions are alike. We'll not presume to prescribe what yours should be. Rather, we'll help you see the power of crafting yours together and using it as a guide, starting now. Embrace the four-way view. To move toward your vision together, you need to take an honest look at how things are now. In order to do so, you'll take the four-way view and notice how the different parts of your life are interconnected. Taking stock of how happy you are and how well you're performing in the different aspects of your life serves as a powerful and practical motivator. It moves you to make changes and not just mindlessly maintain the status quo. But not only do you need to reflect on your own life, you need to candidly communicate at least some of this information with your partner, children, and other important people. Even our friends and family members don't always grasp how we're feeling about the different parts of our lives and how important these arenas are to us. Revealing a full picture of our lives sometimes means getting honest about the darker side of parenting, like guilt, fear, or the disappointing fact that sometimes parenting isn't quite the fulfilling endeavor we were told it should be. But effective leaders don't hide from reality because it's uncomfortable or inconvenient. You will gain the self-awareness you need to understand yourself in new ways, and so communicate more genuinely and compassionately, for your own benefit and that of your key relationships. Engage your children. We expect you will be surprised to learn just how much and what your children have to say about your lives together. We'll help you begin age-appropriate dialogues about the values essential to your family and the vision of your future together. You'll uncover some of the crucial messages you are implicitly and explicitly sending to your children, some of which you may want to revise, and you'll enrich the quality of your connection with your children by drawing them closer. Beyond that, you'll get to hear their creative, often dumbfounding, and sometimes downright hilarious suggestions about what you might try together as a family. One single father in our research, Dominic Martin, discovered that his 4-year-old son, Leo, desperately wanted Dominic to teach him how to do new things. When Dominic inquired further, it turned out that Leo specifically wanted to learn how to vacuum. Not only were they able to identify a shared value, learning new things together, but Dominic got some newfound help with household chores, freeing up a bit of time for other things. You may be surprised to learn that your children don't necessarily need or want you to spend a lot more time with them. Rather, they may want you to put away your phone and your to-do list and just be present, both physically and psychologically. Doable but head-turning ideas can emerge when you open channels of communication and enlist your children in making changes. Connect with colleagues. For many of us, work not only is a source of income, but also shapes our identity. Our careers affect our self-confidence, inform our sense of purpose, and enable our social affiliations. Despite the central role of work in our lives, though, many of us don't dedicate much time to thinking proactively about when, where, or how we work. We often assume that our conditions of work are set in stone, and that the only way to survive is to adjust everything other than work to accommodate its demands. We cut sleep, relaxation, time with our children, all in deference to what we think is expected from us in our careers and from our colleagues. For some of us, unpredictable and grueling hours are unavoidable. For many of us, though, they just seem unavoidable. Our research has revealed practical ways to make changes at work that improve our lives outside work and allow us to be more productive in our jobs. But those opportunities for change need to be unearthed. No one gives them to us. Bosses, colleagues, subordinates, clients, investors, former coworkers, and mentors all are part of the web of people who can help us succeed as parents. When people talk about the connection between work and family, they often articulate a leave your personal life at the door approach. But we are all who we are, no matter where we are, and who we are in our careers affects our children's lives, including their emotional health. We will show you how to strengthen the relationships central to your career so that you have a network of colleagues who want to see you thrive at work, but also outside of work, especially as a parent. Cultivate your community. An ancient, oft-repeated proverb says that it takes a village to raise a child. But what you may not often hear is how to build and keep that village in these modern times. Too many working parents feel disconnected from all but a few people in their work and home lives. In order to succeed as a family, you need to get other people on board, community members, caregivers, friends, and extended family, and to do so in a way that makes them feel good about their relationship with you. You probably feel, like most working parents, that you don't have enough time to invest in any more relationships. But we'll show you how building your village brings you not only a sense of belonging, community, and connection, but also genuine support. The investment is worth it. You'll learn to shift how you think about relationships, each of you on your own and together as a partnership, and you'll begin to identify opportunities to strengthen existing relationships so they tap into new areas of your life, bringing tangible benefits. If you're like most people we have seen grow through this process, you will feel replenished as you better understand the support that's actually available to you in your world. Try a new way. It's common to feel trapped in chains of our own making. We often fail to note how one part of life affects the others, and so miss opportunities to find the freedom to make things better when we learn to see the whole and act to change it. It's more fruitful to think of a pool rather than a prison, to see how a pebble thrown into the pool ripples out, over time, affecting all the roles we play. You'll learn to see interconnections between your family, career, community, and personal lives. We'll help you uncover opportunities to improve the performance and well-being of all those in your family. Smart experiments you'll plan together will revitalize your world. We'll tell you stories of families, some we expect may be much like yours, who were skeptical that they could change how they face the demands of the different parts of their lives. We'll share with you what they tried, what worked, and what they learned, especially when things didn't turn out as planned. We'll help you grasp the power of small wins and how to use them to leap forward as leaders, as a parenting partnership, and as a family. See yourself differently. As a result of all this reflection, conversation, and experimentation, you'll begin to view yourself differently. You'll come to see yourself leading in ways you have not before. Instead of feeling as though you're just surviving, barely keeping your head above water, you will see yourself going strong, like a skilled swimmer in life's waters. We'll help you reflect on what you've learned and how you've grown to solidify your parenting partnership as something like a leadership team. We hope you find yourself fueled by your mutual commitment to a shared future, capable of continual growth and able to inspire others along the way. Your children, of course, but also your colleagues, neighbors, extended family, caregivers, and friends. We'll teach you how to keep the momentum going after you finish this book, inspiring those around you to continuously reflect, connect, and learn together. Get started. The ideas we're about to teach you are straightforward guidance for creating meaningful, sustainable change. The tough part is actually investing the time to work through these steps thoughtfully, interactively, and openly. Go at your own pace, but avoid the temptation to rush through the exercises. Find a way to write or record your responses to them that works for you. You can access helpful resources at parentswholead.net. Being parents who lead requires both individual and collective thought and action. Any strong partnership begins with individuals who have well-founded ideas and aspirations. The challenge, the fun and creative part, is bringing your ideas together. We'll ask you to do this in each chapter after you've prepped separately, to make something new that neither could do without the other. On your own, together. On your own, together. That's the weave. That's the sequence we recommend. We are confident it'll be worth your while. Take it from another of our workshop participants, Lily Conrad, a project manager, practicing Buddhist, and mother to 3-year-old Zaina. We asked her for advice she'd give to you, and here's what she said. You're going to think this is a really big pain in the ass, and there is some pain, but the outcome and the results are phenomenal. All of the difficulty that you have, figuring out who you are and what you value, and figuring out who your partner is, and then connecting, is all worth it at the end. Reflecting, writing, and talking to each other, as we recommend, can seem like a big inconvenience added to already strenuously busy lives. It takes time. It forces you to recognize some truths about yourselves and your lives, and it may lead to some difficult conversations. But there's benefit to be gained from intentionally disrupting the status quo. Identify your own goals. The very first step is for you, as an individual, to think and jot down what you hope to get out of this book and doing the exercises we offer. Write down your responses to the prompts, so you can refer back to them later and then share them with your partner. Find a quiet spot and take 10 minutes to compose your responses. 1. We know you're busy, so why take time out of your schedule to do these things? What's in it for you? For your children? For your career? For your important relationships? In other words, in an ideal world, how would you think, feel, and act differently after you're done with this book? 2. What about this book are you most looking forward to? 3. What's your greatest source of dread? Before we ask you to share your goals with your partner in parenting, let's review some guidelines for working together as a team and enjoying it. You might actually find it exciting and quite possibly romantic. Of course, it will probably be frustrating at times, too. Do your level best to avoid making assumptions about what your partner really means, wants, or needs. It's often those partners who have known each other the longest who gain the most from these conversations, because they're so used to speaking in shorthand and rarely stop to challenge their assumptions. Ask thoughtful questions and encourage your partner to explain thoughts and feelings more deeply. Then listen. By doing so, you not only improve your understanding of each other, but deepen your understanding of yourselves. These are critical conditions for lasting growth. You don't need to agree with everything your partner says or does. We can pretty much guarantee you won't. You can have different goals, values, and approaches, and still work together to support one another as parents and in your separate lives. Speak compassionately and respectfully to one another, and realize that these potentially difficult conversations are important steps in moving toward the future you want. Be smart about how you work together. Use what you already know about each other to find what works best for you in how you take up the exercises we prescribe. Some partners find that reading each other's writing and the activities enables a more carefully considered exchange of ideas. Others prefer to just talk it out. Some find that having these conversations in the evenings after the children are asleep offers a serene opportunity for connection. Others find they're too tired and cranky late at night. You are the experts on you. Don't be afraid to try out different ways of approaching this book, both on your own and with your partner. Working together, coaching each other, as opposed to doing this sort of work on your own, makes it much easier to get unstuck, to move in a direction you want to go, because you can provide both support and accountability pressure, in a good way, for each other. Identify your shared goals. Share your goals for participating in this work with your parenting partner. Once you've done so, specify both the shared and the unique reasons each of you wants to do this project by writing responses to these questions. 1. What are the things you have in common as goals for this venture? 2. What goals are unique to each of you? 3. What did you discover by discussing your goals for the journey ahead? Find the right support. We have a few more comments to set the stage before you go further. We are organizational scholars, experts in the fields of both leadership and the relationship between work and the rest of life. We are parents, but we are not marriage counselors. Although Stu did work with families in the 70s when he was studying clinical psychology and training as a therapist, nor are we pediatricians, child guidance counselors, or early education specialists, though we do address directly the physical and mental health needs of children, drawing in part on research Stu conducted in one of the few studies on the impact of parents' careers on the emotional health of their children. We provide you with research-based guidance on what we know, but if specific challenges unique to your family emerge that require the expertise of a specialist, we encourage you to seek out their support. There is no shame in seeking help of all kinds. Indeed, doing so can, and we believe, should be a source of pride. And it will serve as a good model for your children that it's okay to acknowledge problems and to ask for help.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.